Hey everybody, in this video, I am going to describe various components involved in running a drone simulation with PX4, Q ground control software as our ground control software, Gazebo simulator and ROS. PX4 firmware or PX4 autopilot is the firmware which we use on our drone to control it. In our simulation, it communicates with ROS, Q ground control or any other ground control software and Gazebo simulator through Mavlink communication protocol. Mavlink is a protocol for micro air vehicle which is used to transmit data like vehicle position, vehicle orientation, GPS location and speed. With PX4 on software in the loop, it will communicate with other parts of the software through a UDP layer using Mavlink communication protocol. It will connect with our simulator or the Gazebo simulator we are using. It will connect to it through Mavlink protocol through TCP with a random port. It will also connect with Q ground control, that is our ground control software, through UDP. It will also connect to the ROS through UDP. The connection layers we are using in our simulation might be different in a real world scenario. Like UDP and TCP connections we are using in our simulation might be different. We can use things like serial communication over UART, that is universal asynchronous receiver transmitter. This was just the overview of how things communicate or connect with each other. Let's see the things in detail now. Here I have created a diagram with all the parts of our simulation. Here we have our ROS graph, PX4 firmware, Gazebo simulated world, ground control software, which is Q ground control in our case. Now let's look at PX4 on software in the loop. Let's start with Gazebo simulated world, which will be the replacement for our drone. Just like our drone, we can have things like sensors, motor controllers, etc. We can have robot model, which will be the visual representation of our robot or the drone. We can also have random obstacles or obstacles of our choice. We can also put ground texture and other variables can also be set. So Gazebo is a very advanced simulation software for our drone, which can publish the sensor data and take the input for motors. PX4 firmware will take the input data and through Mavlink companion, it will publish the data to ROS. The motor output can also be fed to Gazebo simulated world and the output will also be sent to ground control software for the visualization of the drone, how it's working. Basically the feedback will also be sent to ground control software. Other than that, our PX4's firmware or the PX4 autopilot will control our Gazebo simulated world drone and it will communicate with ROS and ground control software through Mavlink protocol. Let's see the ROS graph. The main thing to see here is the path planner and how all the nodes come to this. So the PX4 firmware will take input from ground control software. We can set the mission constraints through our ground control software. It will send the constraints or the information through Mavlink protocol. The Mavlink ground controller of our PX4 firmware will take the input. The PX4 firmware will publish the data through Mavlink companion to ROS and the data will be fetched by MavROS node and then the data will be feeded to mission control node, which publishes the data to Mav server node and path planner. So the path planner will calculate the path for our drone and it will feed the data back to our PX4 firmware. The PX4 firmware will send back the data to ground control software and through a feedback loop, the data will be shown on the ground control software, which we will see in a moment. So this is how everything works. ROS is a robot operating system. PX4 is the autopilot or the pilot firmware, which takes the data from sensors and control all the motors. Ground control software is the software which we use to control our drones. And this is just for the simulation. In real world, the ground control software may connect to the drone through Wi-Fi or any other wireless connection. During the development process, it can also be USB to UART bridge. The same PX4 firmware will also work on the real world drone. That's it for PX4 on Software in the Loop. Let's see a demo now. To launch the simulation, I will go to the source folder which I have created and where I have put my firmware. If I go back, I also have PX4 autopilot, but here I will use PX4 firmware. Here I can run sudo make PX4 Software in the Loop default with Gazebo. And after giving my password, it will run the simulation and open up Gazebo. Now the simulation has been started. Here we can see our drone, and I'll fire up my Q ground control software now. So I have started Q ground control software. I also have created a mission. This is just a very simple mission. To start the mission, I can just slide it in and it will take off. You can see the drone here. Drone is flying now. Other data can be seen here. So drone is flying and it is moving to all the positions I have set. It is basically completing the mission from starting node to end node. Now it has completed the mission. What we can do, we can just land the drone on the position which is the end position, or we can say the drone to return to its original position. I am going to return the drone to its original position. So here is our drone. It is returning to its original position. So that's all for this video. I have explained all the nodes which are used for this simulation, how everything is communicating, and this was the simulation itself. Thanks. Peace. Bye.